Hello friends, my name is Vivek Vasant Pandit. I am in 5th standard. My school name is Nam Bharati Vidya Mandir. Today we learn types of plants. There are million plants in our world. Some are big, some are small, some are green patches on land. Some bear flower, it's called flowering plants, and some not bear flower, it's called non-flowering plants. There are 5 types of plants. First is tree, second is shrub, third is herb, fourth is creeper, and fifth is climber. First is tree. Tall and woody plants are called tree. They have hard and thick stem, it's called trunk. They have branches on the upper part of the stem. Example of tree is mango tree, neem tree, etc. Second is shrub. Small than tree and big than herb, it's called shrub. Shrub is medium size of tree. Shrub small than 3 meter. Example of shrub, orange, cotton, etc. Third is herb. Small than shrub, it's called herb. Herb is small than 1 meter. The example of herb is mint, weed, etc. Fourth is creeper. Those plants which different from tree, shrub, herb. They creep along because they have weak stem and heavy fruits. The example of creeper is watermelon and cucumber. Fifth is climber. Climber is weak stemmed plant. They do not creep along. They stand erect with the help of any support. The example of climber is and money plant. Now we learn about plant system. Plant system. First is shoot system and second is root system. This is the diagram of plant system. This is the shoot system and this is the root system. The shoot system is above the ground and root system is below the ground. In shoot system includes such as orchid, flower, bird, leaf, branches, and stem. In root system, primary root and secondary root. Now we learn about root system. Root absorb water and minerals from the soil and transfer to the stem. There are two systems of root system. First is taproot system. And second is fiber root system. I will show you the diagram of taproot system and fiber root system. taproot system and this is a diagram of fiber root system. The taproot is a single and thick root, it's called taproot. And fiber root system is the opposite of taproot system. In fiber root system, our root are in bunch. The root look like hair-like structure. We learn about shoot system. In shoot system, we learn about stem. Stem absorb water and minerals from root and transfer to the other part of plant. The stem show us node and internode. This is a diagram of node and internode. This is called node and this called internode. Node. From place leaf is grow or arise, it's called as node. And internode, the distance between two nodes is called as internode. In short system, we learn about leaf. Leaf known as kitchen of the tree. Leaf make food for tree. This is a diagram of part of leaf. There are five part of leaf. First is leaf blade, second is petiole, third is midrib, fourth is vein, fifth is small midrib vein. First, leaf blade or leaf lamina. The flat surface of leaf is called as leaf blade or leaf lamina. Second is petiole. The stalk of leaf is called as petiole. Third is midrib. Midrib attached to the petiole, they carry water and food to the other part of leaf. And fourth is vein. Vein is attached to the midrib. Now we learn about photosynthesis. This is a picture of hibiscus flower. There are four parts of flower. First is sepal, second is petal, third is stamen, and fourth is carpel. First is sepal. Sepal are green in color. Sepal are five in number. Sepal protect flower in bud condition. And sepal is first part of flower. Second is petal. Petals are beautiful. Petals are bright in color. Petals are attractive part of flower. They attract butterfly and insect to us for the pollination. Third is stamen. Stamen is the male reproductive part of the flower. And stamen is important part of flower. Stamen anthers look like kidney shaped, and filament is the stalk of anther, is called filament. And fourth is carpel. Carpel is the male reproductive, female reproductive part of flower. Carpel is also important part of flower. Carpel consists three part. First is stigma, second is style, third is ovary. The stigma is the upper part of the flower, and style is look like tubular, and ovary is the basal part of the flower. Now we learn about pollination. Pollination. The transfer of pollen grains anther to stigma is called as pollination. There are three agents of pollination. First is by wind. Second is by water. Third is by insect. First, by wind. When strong wind comes, the pollen grains flow with air and transfer this flower anther to another flower stigma. This is the by wind pollination. Second is by water. When water comes in pressure, then pollen grains flow with water and transfer to this flower anther and anther to another flower stigma. Third is by insect. By insect. When this insect fly in air, we learn in a previous lecture the petals are attached to part of the flower. Then petal attract this insect to the and the insect sat on this flower anther, and pollen grains stick on his legs, and he fly to another flower stigma. And this is a by insect pollination.